One of the interesting applications of the line integral of a scalar field is to compute the arc lengths of curves, or if you have a closed curve, to compute the perimeter. So the arc length P of a curve C is given by P is the integral over the curve of ds. So we're just adding up all of the little lengths of the curve. So here the function is just equal to 1. As a reading problem, I ask you to prove that the circumference of a circle is 2 pi times the radius, the well-known result, by computing this type of integral. Here, I want to tackle a more challenging problem, which is the perimeter of an ellipse. It turns out that there is no closed form formula for the perimeter of an ellipse, like 2 pi r. So we'll end up with an integral that is actually a very famous integral. So let's set up the problem for the ellipse. So we're looking at an ellipse. We'll choose in the xy plane. So we have our ellipse here. The major axis will be have a length a, and the minor axis will have a length b. The equation for the ellipse is well known. It's x over a squared plus y over b squared equal to 1. And there's a number that characterizes an ellipse that's called the eccentricity, e. So e is equal to the square root of 1 minus b over a squared. So here a is supposed to be larger than b. And this is called the eccentricity. Okay. So we're going to then compute the perimeter of the ellipse, this arc length. We're going to do that then by parameterizing the ellipse. So the parameterization of the ellipse is going to be x equals a cosine theta, y is equal to b sine theta, right? So x over a squared is cosine squared theta. Y over b squared is sine squared theta, and that's equal to 1. So this parameterizes the ellipse, and theta then goes from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, what is dx then? Dx is equal to minus a sine theta d theta, and dy is equal to b cosine theta d theta. So our ds then is the square root of dx squared plus dy squared, right? And what does that work out to? That's equal to the square root of a squared sine squared theta plus b squared cosine squared theta. And then we have a d theta squared, so square root of that gives us a d theta. Okay. How do we manipulate this? Well, I would like to see the eccentricity in this formula, right? This is going to be what we integrate over. So let me put it up here. So our ds then. So this is a b over a, so I should factor out an a. So we have an a. And then I want to somehow combine terms. So I would like to write everything in terms of cosine. So we have square root. So that will be sine squared theta. So instead of sine squared theta, we can write 1 minus cosine squared theta for sine squared theta. And then we factored out an a, so we have a b over a squared plus b over a squared, and also a cosine squared theta. Okay, and times d theta. Okay, so we're looking for the eccentricity. So we have a cosine squared here and a cosine squared here, and we're looking for a 1 minus b over a, so I can write that as a. And then we have a square root, we have a 1, and then we have a, we want a 1 minus b over a, so we can say minus here, and then we have a 1 from the, we're going to multiply by cosine squared theta, so we have a minus cosine squared theta, and then we have a plus here and a minus here, so that would be a minus b over a squared. And that whole thing then is multiplying cosine squared theta d theta. Okay, a little bit messy math to do in my head, but it's okay. We can then replace this by our eccentricity. So this becomes a times the square root of 1. The eccentricity is the square root of this thing, so 1 minus e squared cosine squared theta d theta. Okay, we're almost done. We put that together. Then the formula for the perimeter of an ellipse is the integral over the curve ds is then going to be, in terms of the parameter, theta goes from 0 to 2 pi. And then our ds is a, which comes out of the integral, times the square root of 1 minus e squared cosine squared theta d theta. And that is usually, so cosine squared theta goes between theta equals 0 and pi over 2. It goes from 1 to 0. Then from pi over 2 to pi, it goes from 0 to minus 1, but we're squaring it. And then it goes from minus 1 back to 0, when it goes from pi to 3 pi over 2. And then from 3 pi over 2 to 2 pi, it goes from 0 back to 1. So there's kind of like 4 equal contributions to this integral. So you usually then multiply by 4, so 4 times a, and then you write this as an integral from 0 to pi over 2 of root 1 minus e squared cosine squared theta d theta. Okay? And then one more thing. It doesn't matter whether this one is cosine theta or sine squared theta. Cosine squared theta or sine squared theta. It's the same integral. Cosine squared theta goes from 1 to 0. Sine squared theta goes from 0 to 1. So it's exactly the same value. So usually when you look at this, say, on Wikipedia, you would see a sine squared rather than a cosine squared. That's a formula for the perimeter of an ellipse. It turns out not to be able to do this integral analytically. And this integral then has actually a very nice name. I'm going to squeeze the writing of the name in here. This is called the complete elliptic integral of the second kind. Okay? The complete elliptic integral of the second kind. Okay, that opens up a lot of questions. What's the incomplete elliptic integral? What's the elliptic integral of the first kind? There's a lot of math in this formula, but this comes from just computing the perimeter of an ellipse. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.